G'day guys, welcome back to part two of building the Soleil Royale. I've been looking ahead in the instructions, and this is the next part that needs to be fitted into the skeleton of the ship. Now what's supposed to happen is I'm supposed to fit 12R and 12L one on each side, and then below that 16L and 16R directly below it. But I'm going to do it a little bit different. I'm actually going to fit these parts, let me just adjust the camera again, I'm actually going to fit these parts while they're out here. I think it's going to be easier to get them square than if they're sitting upright. So I'll do that, then fit the top two, and then fit it into the skeleton of the ship. So we'll start doing that now. Okay, so I'll leave that one to dry and then do the other side, and for me that'll take about 4 hours, for you it'll be just about instant. Next up we have parts 12R and 12L, which fits into its corresponding slots over here. Okay, we'll just let them dry and then we'll back shortly. Now that the forward frame is all dry and finished and nicely square, we can put that on, but first I'm going to attach this little tab, number 17, just goes into here. On most ships I've done, I would have thought that would be to support the one of the masts, but it seems a bit too far forward, so I'm not sure what that's exactly for. On the drawings it says to put it in there after putting the forward frame in, but I just think it'll be easier doing it this way. Shouldn't have to check that one, because I think these parts along here should hold it nice and square. Just put a little bit extra glue down that seam. Next up, we have a number of braces that need to go on. Two part 13s on the sides, that way. And then we have parts 14 and 15 that will brace it that way. So I'll just check where it sits. I think that's right. I'll just double check the instructions and we'll glue it in place if it is. Okay, part 13 will slide in here right to the back of that first frame. Same on the other side, and then the in-between braces will go between the two of them. So I'll just get that ready. that's in there, and I'll finish the other side and get back to you when we put the cross braces in. One thing I've just realised is I didn't actually record putting in parts 13 and 14 and 15, the cross braces, but there's not much to it. You just put each side in, then the cross beam, and I had no trouble and they just seemed to fit in perfectly. So yeah, sorry about that, but we'll keep going. Next up, we'll be extending the keel, another four slots. So we'll just get some glue and set that up. Okay. As before, we've just got to put these little supports each side. Okay, and that's that bit, so we'll just leave that to dry. And we can start adding the pieces that go on through this section here. Okay, the parts we're going to be putting in are just like this. They slide in at the front, all the way around. So we've got parts 20L, 21L, 25L, 26L and 27L. Now there's no way I can put these in without just you seeing the back of my hand for the whole operation, which I seem to be pretty good at so far. But so what I'll do is I'll show you the end result. Okay, they're all in. So we'll just let that all dry and then we'll continue. Okay, next three parts we've got. We've got the little tab that goes in where I think the one of the masks sits upon. That will just sit in behind this last frame in here. in like that. And then we have our two braces. And again, it just shows you the numbers of each frame that sits in there. Not that far enough. One's being a little bit stubborn, there it goes. And then the other side. Okay, that's in. Yeah, so that completes step 39. So we'll leave the video there and we'll be back next week. Thanks for joining me.